Welcome back to The Price of Business. I'm your host, Kevin Price, talking to you about you and your business. Sullivan Alexander, he's an outstanding Price of Business contributor, a genius when it comes to business efficiency and taking companies to the next level, which is why we have him as a contributor on this program. And one of our most prolific writers over at priceofbusiness.com with several new articles that I'm going to be, that I've been promoting recently and will be promoting later on in the program. Sullivan, as always, delighted to have you on the program. Welcome.
Yeah, thanks for having me there, Kevin.
Always. Hey, real quickly, kind of give us a little bit of an overview of your company before you introduce your guest today.
Okay, well, our company is Contra Business Advisors. We're really a one-stop trusted business advisory firm for small to mid-sized businesses. Our mission is really to provide small to mid-sized companies with business advice, information technology, and real-time accounting services.
Very good. Boy, you must have said that before. Tell us about your guest today.
Well, our guest today is Alex Brown. He is the CEO of 10th Magnitude. It's a cloud software and services firm based out of Chicago, Illinois. And welcome to the show, Alex.
Thanks very much, Sullivan.
Alex, we're delighted to have you. Kind of give us your elevator speech. Tell us what your company is all about.
Sure thing. So my firm is a custom software development firm focused on building custom applications for business in the cloud. So we work with small and mid-sized businesses, and because of the economics of the cloud, we can give them the technology they've always dreamed of to go after the markets they've always wanted to and let them punch above their weight and compete with the big guys who previously were the only folks who could afford this stuff.
Awesome. Go ahead, Sullivan.
All right. Well, in talking with Alex earlier, one of the things that it seems as though between Alex's firm and our firm, there are some similarities when it comes to the benefits of moving to the cloud. Alex, can you talk a bit more about those benefits of migrating to the cloud?
Sure, absolutely. So there's a number of really powerful benefits and transformational benefits for business of the cloud. The most critical piece is the ability to kind of change the investment profile of undertaking new product development or launching new lines of business. So essentially what the cloud does is it means you no longer have to take on the capital risk of acquiring a lot of equipment. You no longer have to take on the operational risk of hiring additional resources, additional staff, and all of the costs associated with that. So these systems can now be built to launch a new line of business or to launch a new product without all of that upfront risk and all of that upfront capital requirement, which means then as your business grows, you just continue to pay for what you're using. And what that translates into is businesses can now take on new initiatives that before were just too risky and frankly, cost prohibitive.
Yeah, tell me a little bit, how old is the company that that you have here?
Sure. We're 2.5 years old. We got started late in 2010.
Yeah, that's interesting. And so you came on board, you created your business intending to be a primarily in the cloud business, unlike so many companies out there that were really software companies in the traditional sense of the word and had to make that very difficult transition. You started day one as one who operated in the cloud.
That's exactly correct. From day one, we've always been focused purely on the cloud. It's clear the future of where technology is going, and we, as a result, it's enabled us to grow, more aggressively than I think we would have had we gone down the traditional path.
Very good. Go ahead there.
Yeah, Alex, in terms of one of the things I've seen over the years is sometimes IT departments are a little bit reluctant to come on board with moving or migrating to the cloud here. I think some of them see their functions or roles are historically been more along the maintenance side of the systems. Can you maybe talk a bit more about the maintenance and what they can do differently when they migrate?
Sure. No, I'd be happy to. And that's a great insight that you just talked about, that a number of larger organizations are now starting to get to. And so our customer base has started to change over the last 6 months. Is now a number of large kind of $1 billion-plus size organizations are tapping into our capabilities to help them. So the point you touched on about kind of the organization changing is a very powerful concept within the cloud. So essentially, in the cloud, you're basically tapping into another organization's operational expertise to keep the machines running. So in our case, our primary partner is Microsoft. They are great at keeping servers running and software running and making sure things are secure. So you no longer have to worry about that. There's a lot of IT organizations who's basically today, that's their primary task. to keep the lights running and to keep the machines running, their jobs can change in the cloud. And it's frankly a very scary proposition for some organizations to change like that. But if you can tap into it, it's very powerful, because what it means is instead of spending all this money keeping the lights running, now you can redirect those people. So now they can align with the business and figure out how to drive new systems forward, innovate around the core applications that the business needs to grow revenue. And all of a sudden they become revenue enhancers instead of a cost center. That's phenomenal for these companies. They can grow much more aggressively now with exactly the same resources. Mm-hmm. So it's not that their roles go away, it's that they change, and change is always hard and it's always scary. And organizations are grappling with that now.
Yeah. Let me ask a question. So, you know, it seemed to me, you know, like we mentioned earlier, that there was a lot of ugly transition going on by traditional software companies into the cloud. Was that something that you saw that you could exploit the lag that was taking place for a lot of those companies going into this sphere?
We have been able to kind of exploit that dynamic a bit, because you know some of the traditional firms, right, frankly, have been very slow to move, because this is a new way of thinking, it's a new way of doing business, and that slowness has created opportunity because their clients are impatient and their clients need to keep their businesses going. So that's given us opportunity to go in and essentially kind of supplant some of these older style folks who are moving too slowly. They're not embracing the new model. They're not embracing the new economics. And that's created opportunity for us, frankly, to come in and become the trusted advisor to help these organizations move in a different direction that was strategic for their organization and helped them accelerate growth.
Yeah, very good. Go ahead, Sullivan.
All right. Can you just tell us about the challenges your business has faced during the economic recovery?
Sure. So, so it's interesting. So we face a different set of, challenges during the recovery than you traditionally hear about. So we got started, you know, when the economy was really not yet recovering, right? So it was 2010. Yeah. And that actually opened up a lot of opportunity for us because, when times are tough, people are looking for new ways to do things and to keep their business growing and thriving. And we offered that with these cloud strategies. So created a lot of opportunity for us. However, the challenge was twofold. One was helping organizations kind of learn about the new technology and learn to accept it. There was, initially with any new piece of technology, there's always some skepticism. So we had to help them overcome concerns about security and data privacy. And we by and large done that. And the smaller organizations really embraced the model. So that was one challenge. Second challenge, though, is from a labor market perspective, as we grew, it is very, very hard to find qualified, high-performing software engineers. Mm-hmm. The market is really constrained. There are not enough talented engineers out there. We're not creating enough and having enough new talent enter the market. So hiring people has really been a struggle.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, and that's kind of it's interesting. Even with the high unemployment, not so much in the high skill set. Isn't that true?
That's exactly right. I mean, in Chicago, where we do the bulk of our hiring today, unemployment within the software rank is low single digits, 1 or 2%. I mean, it's functionally, there is no unemployment. It's mm-hmm. tough. And you got to find good people who already have jobs, and you have to essentially recruit them to come over here because we're doing more interesting work and we're doing cool stuff and they want to get involved.
All right. Speaking Absolutely. Of cool stuff, this interview was very cool with my friend Sullivan Alexander, a Price of Business contributor, and really anyone's brain trust. You need someone like him in your corner navigating you through the financial situations that we're all facing. Sullivan Alexander, his website is Contour Advisors. That's Contoure advisors.com. And then his guest today, Alex Brown, he's with 10thmagnitude.com. 10th is spelled, is a number, 10thmagnitude.com. Two outstanding guests. Guess who's going to get his tongue bobbed after the program? Outstanding guests here today and really enjoyed it so much. Thanks to both of you gentlemen.
Thank you so much, Kevin. Thanks so much.
Sullivan, always looking forward to your future interviews. I am Kevin Price. Don't forget the best content here shows up over there at usdailyreview.com. While there, like it on Facebook, follow it on Twitter.